Hallelujah. No. Oh my goodness. Hallelujah. Bless God. Hallelujah. Bless God. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. Hallelujah. God, you are so good. Just so, so good. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Victory. Hallelujah. All praise rises to Christ the King. By your spirit, resurrected King, resurrected me. Hallelujah. Bless God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, it is 5:01 and 5:01. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome, Pastor Cynthia. Hallelujah. I am waiting on Pastor Marcia to hop on. Prayed against any technical difficulties because it seems like sometimes I, because of the settings, I think I can't bring people on if it doesn't give me the option. So I'm hoping and praying that that's not the case for her. There's Pastor Marcia. I see she's watching. Okay, let's see if it gives me the option to bring her on. It does not. Ah! All right, see, that's what I was afraid of. Pastor Marcia, on your end, do you see anywhere where it says ask to join my video? Because it's not giving me the option to add you, which is what I was afraid of. Uh-huh. Da, 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 da. Ay, ay, ay. I do not. Okay. I do not see the add button. I do not see the add button for you, Pastor Marcia. You know what? Pastor Marcia, I can't hear you. I can't add you either. So if you can hear me, and if you're on a laptop, it usually doesn't work. You have to be on your phone. And then it gives me the option to add. Try, are you on with your phone or your laptop? I don't know if an iPad will work. Is there any options on the bottom that say that says request to join video that you can send me a request? Welcome, Lola. Sorry, we're trying to figure out how to get Pastor Marcia on because I don't have the option to add her. So, done. Let's see. Okay, on my phone. Hold on, let me see. Okay, on your phone, on the bottom of the phone, there should be some icons like a star, a microphone, a camera, a link. And there's a little box with two people in there. If you click on that box, if you see that box, you can request. There we go. Approve. Unable to add. They can't join your broadcast. Oh, how come? Ah, it must be a setting. Approve. Okay, I see the invite, Pastor Marcia, but now it's not letting me, even though I click approve, it's saying, they can't, you can't join my broadcast. Why? What's going on? Okay. Let's see. I was afraid of that. Okay. So that means there's a setting on your Facebook that's not allowing, it's probably private, so it's not allowing me to bring you on with me. So here's what I'm going to try to do, because I really want to hear what you have for us. So I'm going to jump off of the live. And Pastor Marcia, I want you to see if you can just jump on my page like you can on Bootcamp without me, and just go ahead and preach. Give your word, amen. You know, at some point I got to figure out how to do these lives for people who have different settings on their pages and stuff. But for now, I really want to hear what you have. So I'm going to hang up. I'm going to get off the live. Everybody, get off, and let's see if Pastor Marcia can jump on, and then we will jump on her live and watch her. I could find your live button. Oh, wait, hold on. I see you. Let's see if it works now. Wait. Oh, yes. Maybe it's working. Oh, yes, it did.
I'm on my phone.
After all of that, right?
All of that.
Hallelujah. I was like, I gotta get her on. I'm anxious for her word.
I got it. Okay, there. Oh, now you can see my face.
Better. Yes. Oh, my goodness. Okay, goodness. I'm glad we were able to get you on.
Wait, 1 second. I have to make sure. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, good. That's the main thing. You can hear me. Sorry about that.
That's okay. I'm just glad we're able to get you on. It's like
I was trying earlier.
I'm thinking, God, I need to find a way to do this when people's settings are different. Come on, help me out. Holy Spirit, come on.
Barely, I hear you. Oh. It's next. We're all learning how to use this.
Right. Right. Amen.
Learning how to use this too, but it's a great tool if you get it to work right.
it is a great tool for ministry and reaching people, right? Amen. All right, well, before we start, I'm going to open in prayer. Father, I just thank you. I thank you for this time that you've set aside for Real Talk. I thank you for working out the technical difficulties so that we could get Pastor Martha on here. God, I am so blessed. I pray that you would give us ears to hear and eyes to see what the Spirit is going to speak through Pastor Marcia in this time. In the mighty name of your son, Jesus, amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to introduce, for those of you, because there's people on already, this is Pastor Marcia Gomes from Kona Christian Church. She also does Women of Destiny and Hawaii Healing Revival. I'll let her talk more about that if she wants to. And I'm excited for your word. So go ahead. I don't want to take any more time.
I was kind of wondering what it is you wanted me to talk about, because, you know, I could talk about almost anything. And of course, if you want me to talk about what's on my heart right now, you know, what God is doing right now, I can do that. I can do
that. That's exactly what I want.
Oh, okay.
Exactly what I want. God's got on your heart for now.
Well, my heart, what's on my heart right now is revival. God has been impressing that on me for years. And at the beginning of probably this year, I was seeking the Lord to find out what I was going to share at the Women of Worship while working. And he brought back to my vision And he speaks to me in visions, dreams, the word of God. You know, I get a lot of that download from the Lord. So I'm, you know, I could go in many different directions. I've been in it for years, so I can go in a lot of different directions. But the Lord has impressed revival on my heart. And he has always given me a vision dream. And this one was of Mokuaikawa Church here in Kailua Kona. It's the oldest church in Kona. And it has a great history of revival and awakening. And the reason the Lord brought that back to my remembrance was because of the person who was instrumental being used by the Lord in that time frame. Was his name was Titus Cone, Reverend Titus Cone.
Yes,
you remember him?
I remember. I think
a lot of us know him if we study our Christian history, you know, of the islands. And because of that, and I had studied this way before, you know, when I first got this vision, probably 20 years or more, maybe 30 years now, because I've been in the Lord 40 years plus. And when he gave me that vision again, he really spoke to my heart that he wanted me to talk about revival for this life. And of course, that is like a passion of mine, because of the vision of Mokuaikawa Church. And I'll tell you the vision. When I was down in Kailua Kona where Mokuaikawa Church is, and I happened to walk on the grounds, and this was in a dream. And I walked on the grounds, and as I walked on the grounds, I looked at the ground, and it was dry. You know how it gets dry hot in Kailua Kona? But what happened was God opened my eyes to see water under the ground. In other words, there was water there. He says, there is living water under this ground. And then I walked into Mokuaikawa Church. And if you've ever seen Mokuaikawa Church, it's a stone church. Mm-hmm. And it's built of lava rocks. And when I went in, there was in the church a well made of rock, lava rock. And as I looked at this well and I looked at it, it had a lot of rubbish in the well. It wasn't flowing. A lot of rubbish and piled up. Look like many years of rubbish. Now, this is in the dream. And then I knew in my spirit that God was not pleased with this.
Right.
And as I sensed his displeasure, there was a like a rumbling. There was a rumbling. And, you know, God rumbled, you know, the glory rumbles.
Yes.
And when that happened, there was pressure that spewed the rubbish out. It spewed it out, spewed it out until the water came forth. And God said, this is living water. And this living water went all over the grounds and all over. And what the Lord was showing me was that there is living water under your grounds.
Right.
These islands, because of the great awakening that took place with Titus Cone, who was instrumental here on this island and throughout the islands, he says, there's living water. You need to be a voice for revival and another great awakening. God says it's time. And of course, you know, he gives me Haggai, I think is, what was it? Haggai 2:9, you know, the glory of the latter house. So what the Lord was saying is that he wants to do it even greater in these ends. And it's so prime, you know, and just so happened that spurred my heart to, you know, re-study about revival, about the great awakening, because that's my passion. My passion is the power and presence of God.
Yes.
I love everything about the power and presence of God. And so, you know, I began to study, and God impressed on my heart to share this for our luncheon. And the reason why was because Titus Cone comes from Hilo. He started in Hilo. And because of that, before the luncheon, I went to Hilo with my girlfriends to look at the church, Haile Church. Now, and it's so interesting because it reminds me of Mokuaikawa Church. And just so happened, I was talking to the pastor that was there, and I was telling him about my dream, and he says, oh, he had the same dream for here. And I said, you know, yes, the Lord is saying it's here as well, because Titus Cone this is his base. And so that really stirred my spirit.
Right.
And gravesite, you know, I like to research history.
Yes.
Talk about it. You know, I want to know what happened in the former days, because God's going to do a greater work in these last days.
Yeah.
So I did. And more and more, the Lord impressed on me, revival, revival. And he's given me other visions and dreams of revival here on the island. But he said, this is spreading out through all the islands.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
All the islands of Hawaii is being impacted by God for revival.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's so interesting, because this was back in January, February, right? And I was supposed to speak in February. And just so happened, we had this terrible storm.
Right.
And nothing, the luncheon was canceled. And I said, oh, great, Lord, you give me this awesome message. And the luncheon is canceled. And I said, what am I going to do? He said, well, pray, keep praying. You know,
right?
Pray for an open door for revival, but keep on praying. That's what he wants. So I said, okay. And, you know, it kind of grieved my heart because I couldn't share it. But then we went to Kauai,
yes.
Right? And you know what happened in Kauai?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you know my message, right? You heard my message in Kauai.
Yes.
I'm going to share on revival.
Yes.
And it was so interesting because it just stirred my spirit even more to be in Kauai Friday night to see what God was doing with the church.
Amen.
And others, you know, that connected with her, and that she had this vision for revival.
Amen.
So I, oh, praise God. You know, God's still linking me up for revival. I said, okay, Lord. And then that I saw the beginning of revival there.
Mm-hmm.
I saw them working toward revival. I didn't know anything about what Pastor Tammy was going to do.
Mm-hmm.
It was new to me what I saw, but it stirred my spirit, because
right.
I said, goodness, the living water is here as well under the ground.
Yes.
And it was so unique that we went into an old church.
Yes.
And I said, oh my
yes.
goodness,
yes.
you know, it's so God, right, to connect thoughts for me. And I'm going, every time God shows me something, my goodness, yes, Lord, confirmation, there
Amen.
It is. And then on Saturday, I gave the message. Well, you heard my message, because I had a message to talk about revival, but I was so stirred up because God says they're already walking in it. They've already begun. They've already begun to take the steps.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going to bring, and I brought out the five steps, but I brought it out in a different way, and God had totally changed my message because it was already happening. But isn't that God?
He does that, yes.
He stirs us up to stir each other up.
Yes.
Because he's doing a work in all of us.
Mm-hmm.
And it's
Amen.
So wonderful, where there's wonderful confirmation.
Yeah.
And and you heard my message, and I was really fired up.
Yes, yes.
I was totally on fire. And I could have gone longer, but we could have, you know, done more because I was so fired up. And then I told Pastor Tammy I had to talk to her because I wanted to hear what God was doing in her.
Right.
And Amen. What God has said to her. And I know she came on your live.
Yes.
And she shared it.
Yes.
I heard her, you know, and I said, praise God. Well, I called her on the phone the next day. And I told her, I want to hear what God is doing in you. And lo and behold, the same thing God was telling me here, God was telling her there.
Amen.
The confirmation was so intense.
Amen.
And intense. I was just, this is so God. But you know what? He's calling all the islands.
Yes.
And you know, he's stirring all of us up because he wants revival in the state of Hawaii, as
yes.
he wants all over. And you know what was interesting is I was going to speak to WOW in February, and because I couldn't, the next month Ashbury revival took place.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh my gosh, there's another confirmation.
Yes.
Shucks.
Yes.
But
yeah.
you know, God does this with us.
Yes.
You know, he just confirms and confirms and confirms. that he wants revival in our land. And I was blessed with Pastor Tammy and all of her group and what they're all doing, because they're linking up. And that's what we have to do. We have to unify.
Yes, yes.
And we must come together. And God told her the same thing he told me. It's not going to be all the church. It's going to be the remnant. It's going to be those who hear, who have their hearts burning for it, who, you know that it's God and they want to be a part of it.
Yes.
That's exactly the people God is looking for. Yes. He's not looking for the whole church, because not the whole church is there. A lot of the whole church is lukewarm. And so God is looking for those hot and on fire, hearing from the Lord, wanting to be a part. Yes. That's God.
Yes.
And then, you know, I was talking to the pastors in Maui, where you are. Do you go to their church? Pastor, their name slipped me right now.
Where Pastor Shani goes?
Yes, yes.
No,
yes.
We're down at... We're down at KC in Kahului, King's Cathedral.
Oh, King's Cathedral. Oh, okay. So that's a well-known church.
Yeah, yes.
Praise God. Well, I had been talking to, what's the name, Pastor, what's her name?
I want to say Kahului. No. I can see her face.
Names slip me sometimes. I know. It's really bad. But it's Pastor Shani's pastors. And I love them dearly, and I should not forget their name. Their name should be right in my thoughts. Because they also have a heart for revival, you know?
Yes.
And God is stirring it in Honolulu as well. Pastor Cassie. Right, all of them. You know, they're kind of all linked together. And I'm really excited about that, because this is something that we're wanting to do on this island. Now, I do Women of Destiny. Been doing Women of Destiny for 6 years now, and I do Power Encounter, which is another Women of Destiny outlet, and it's mostly for women. And I really minister to women. I find women very hungry for the things of God.
Amen.
I find them very sensitive to the move of the Holy Spirit. Yes. Those that embrace the Spirit of God and the Word of God, not all, you know, but the majority that I minister to, is coming to these functions that we have and these events that we have, because they're hungry. They want more. They want more of the Spirit of God. They want more of God. They want to hear the testimonies. They want to be in the atmosphere of God is present. You can sense the power of God being released in our midst, and he stirs and burns in our hearts the knowledge of his presence, because he's in us. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
And so this is the kind of women we're drawing. And we did the healing revival, which we started, and there was many reasons. Again, because I'm a doer. Mm-hmm. I love to pray, but I'm a doer.
Yes.
I believe when you pray, you need to be doing something.
Yes. Yes.
I don't believe in faith
requires action. You got to take action.
Amen. You've got to do something.
Yes.
And I'm that type, you know. I mean, I do go to a Christian church with my husband. And, you know, I'm doing Women of Destiny, and I'm branching out with Women of Destiny. Yes. Now I feel called to the islands for revival.
Yes, yes.
I just want to connect with anyone who wants revival in our land.
Amen.
We're stirring up revival, ladies. Pray for revival.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Because I believe it's on the heart of God, you know, an outpouring of his Spirit, you know. I love with the work of the Holy Spirit. I love what he's doing.
Amen.
And, you know, he is God. He performs the word with signs following. He is doing this in us. He's directing our steps. He's encouraging us every step of the way. And just being sensitive how he wants to lead us. And that's always the challenge, is really wanting to know how he wants to lead
us. Amen.
So I'm moving in that direction. I'm talking to pastors here to get together, you know, because when I talk to Pastor Tammy, they're getting together. And I like that. I believe that is God.
I
believe that's what the Lord is saying. Yes. Unite, connect, you know, and be on fire for what God wants to do. And so that is our goal, to be on fire for the things of God.
Yes.
And revival is on his heart. We see that throughout the islands, you know, every island, every major island. Mm-hmm. We have here Maui, Honolulu, Kauai, all have a hunger for revival. And I thank God for that. So we know that it is on the heart of God, because when he moves and when he speaks, there's confirmation through those that are hearing him. Yes. And that's what I love. So that's our goal, is to move forward in revival, and as well as praying for what we're doing.
Amen. Excuse me.
And so what I've been focusing on is the Holy Spirit, because, you know, we can declare it, we can decree it. He has to perform. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. He has to burn in the hearts of the people. He has to stir them. He needs to give them visions and dreams. He needs to bring us together, you know, that linking up.
Yes, yes.
That agreement that we want to work together. We want to unify.
Amen.
And we want to do it his way, according to his word. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just being sensitive to how he's going to do that. And not to be ignorant of the fact that the enemy is going to try and throw all kinds of blocks in our way.
Yeah.
And so we have to be mindful that the enemy is going to throw all kinds of darts. He's going to throw all kinds of blocks or wrenches, you know, whatever he can. Mm-hmm. I mean, I experience it as well. And naturally, we have to stand firm.
Yes.
Against the lies of the enemy, you know, because that's his tactic, to lie, to deceive, and, you know, to raise up evil people, to speak evil words. And we cannot go there at all. We can't entertain those lies and those arenas. Yes. We can't entertain the depression or the evil speaking or the, you know, whatever it is that he conjures up.
Yes.
He's always throwing things to our mind, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
He's attacking the mind, and we have to guard our minds, and we need to fill our minds with the word and worship in the spirit. That's why I continually say we need to be hungry.
Amen.
Desperate for what God wants to do in revival in our land.
Amen.
And then pray. The next is pray. Pray for revival. Pray. God, pour out his spirit on all flesh, like his word says, that we have outpourings after outpourings that just move on the people to unite, to gather. And then he says that we need to work with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We need to work with the Holy Spirit. We need to praise and worship God.
Yes.
Declare his glory in the island.
Amen.
Declare his
Yes.
Declare his wonderful works amongst us as the people of God. You know, just make those declarations and make those decrees of the goodness of God and revival in our land. And he will revive us again. And the Spirit of God will quicken our spirit, make us alive in Christ Jesus. Cause us to just flow with the Spirit of God, because he is the supernatural work of God in us.
Amen. Amen.
And he's the genius, not us.
Amen. Two days ago, Pastor Marcia, I was on my Women of War, and I talked about the glory of God and how we carry that glory.
That's
That's the fire of God. And it's, and I keep telling people, like, if we carry that glory on the inside of us, there is no stopping us.
Amen.
You know, I mean, when Israel carried the glory of God, they there was no stopping them.
Yep.
You know? And we know that, you know, Luke 10:19 tells us, right? God has given us all power over all the power of the enemy. And revival starts with us. And if we are carrying that fire, if we're carrying that glory, God's glory on the inside of us, we can't help but want revival.
That's
I mean, it's all about soul saved. Right.
It starts with us. Well, think about it. The Holy Spirit is in us.
The
word of
Amen.
God says he's the greater one in us. He's greater than the one that's in the world today. He can spark the fire. All we have to do is pray, ask him to do it, work in us, revive us, the Lord,
come
you know,
on.
Cause us to burn with the Spirit. You know, cause us to just ignite for Jesus in our declarations, in our worship, in our praise.
Amen. Come on.
Recognize his presence in us.
Yes.
Recognize the power of God in us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. And when we recognize the power of God, he motivates us. He he stirs us up. You know, and we get the goosebumps and the Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, it's like when you said the enemy, you know, is gonna throw all the blocks. Because of course he comes to steal, kill, and destroy, right? But the thing is, the enemy, sometimes I think we sit there and we think, oh, the enemy is attacking us because of our past or because things, you know, he brings those things to remembrance.
That's
but the attacks are because because of what's coming, because of where we are going, because of what God is telling us to do. And he's trying to stop that from happening.
That's his goal, to steal the word. To steal the vision, to steal the dream. He's a stealer.
Yes.
You don't want him to rob you, so you stay out of his camp.
Amen. Amen.
You stay in the Lord's camp.
Amen. If stay
the
in the
word of God,
of God
says, be filled with the Spirit.
Yes.
Burning with the Spirit.
Yes. Yes.
And you can do that all by yourself.
Right. So good. So
you
good.
Have a revival right in you. And then we need to multiply it out.
Yes. Yes.
That's the goal, is to multiply it out.
Yes.
So when I hear of revival starting, you know, like in Kauai and all the islands now starting, I'm just so blessed.
Yes.
I am just so blessed.
Yes.
Because that's the heart of God.
Yes.
In these last days, you know, we have to be about our Father's business.
Yes.
We're not playing church. We're about our Father's business. It's about what he wants to have take place in this earth, because he wants souls to come into the kingdom of God. But he needs his people revived. He needs his people on fire. He needs his people burning with the Spirit and alive and just hungry and thirsty to share the good news of Jesus Christ to the lost, to the hurting. You know, he said the believers will cast out demons and they'll leave.
Amen.
The believers will
and come
speak
on.
With new tongues. And it's we, the believers, that are witnesses for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Because
yes.
the Holy Spirit is in us. And he says that as we hear his voice, he will direct our steps.
Yes.
And he does it by the word.
Yes.
You know, he just brings the word of
yes.
God right back to us,
yes.
you know. And then he says, do it.
Do it. Yes, do it. Just do it.
Just do it. You know, Mary had it right. She said to the people that poured out the water, whatever he
just
says, do it.
Do it. Amen. Amen. Amen.
The miracle will happen.
Right. And, you know, we have that kind of God, right?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
like, I told, you know, I was saying the other day, I was just saying, like, we have the God, the creator. My brain can't conceive this amazing creator that we serve,
yes.
right? That lives
Absolutely.
On the inside of us, that we should be able to trust with everything we have.
Absolutely. Yes.
He knows what's coming, so he's already got the way of escape. You know?
Absolutely.
And I mean, we go to all these great conferences, and I love them, but then what do? We got to take that out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're getting filled so we can pour out. Because if we're not pouring out, then we just become dried up.
Yeah, you got to give it away.
Yeah.
You know, to get
Amen.
More in God, you got to give it away. It said, give and it shall be given to
Amen.
You.
Amen.
So
yes.
we have to give. Give of the love. Give the peace. Give the joy. Give the blessing. Lay hands on the sick. Tell them about Jesus.
Amen.
You know, God needs all of us.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yes. God needs all of us to be witnesses for Christ.
Yes.
You know, we all have our part, and the Holy Spirit is orchestrating the body, and everyone is necessary.
Mm-hmm.
It's all important for the purposes of God and what he's planning. And, you know, when we come together and unify, there is such great power that is released.
Yes.
The great Holy Ghost power.
Yeah.
is released.
Yeah.
And the gifts of the Spirit are in operation. You know, he deposits word of wisdom, word of knowledge, discerning of spirits, special faith, working of miracles, gifts of healing, tongues, interpretation, and prophecy. But he says, in order to operate in those gifts, you got to give it away. Yes. When you're helping someone else, the gifts operate. Yes. Yes. When you're all about you, no gifts.
No. You know.
No gifts. No. Give it away and you get more.
It's like I tell my husband, I said, you know, it comes with a cost. Mm-hmm. If I want to move the way Jesus moved, because he did say greater things than these
shall we do, right? Absolutely.
When he goes to be with his Father. But he paid the price. He separated himself all the time. So you tell the disciples, hey, minister, you go, I'll meet you there. Because he took time with his Father. There was a cost. And if we don't spend time with our Father, if we don't spend time in his word, because that's him. If we don't know this, we don't know him.
That's right.
We have nothing
to
stand
on. He's the word. Like, you have to have the word.
You have to speak that word.
You know, you wanna move of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit will only demonstrate the word of God with signs.
That's in you. Yes.
That is in you. So you speak it, the word of God, he'll demonstrate it. He doesn't demonstrate philosophy. Yes. He doesn't demonstrate theology. He doesn't demonstrate man's ideas. Right. He doesn't. Right. He's not involved in that. He is involved in glorifying Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And Jesus Christ is glorified as we declare the word of God.
Yes.
Because of the Holy Ghost in us to bring that word to life, to cause it to come alive. The word of God is a living, powerful word, right?
Amen.
That's what Hebrews tells us. The word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
Amen. Amen.
It's
Amen.
So powerful.
It is so powerful.
Oh my goodness. And you know, we'll be challenged. I mean, I was challenged just this week. I had a real challenge this week. I have a puppy. My husband decided he wanted a puppy. So we have a puppy. No. My little puppy, he loves to bite. He's playing, but he loves to bite. I swear, I've been working with him and he's bit my hand all over the place. And I got marks because of it. I got my gloves. I told my husband, and this last one he bit me was so deep on my hand, on the back of my hand over here. See, I got all these band-aids. I could feel the bacteria go from that bite straight up my arm, straight up my neck, and down by my heart. And I commanded it in the name of Jesus. You stop bacteria. Yeah. Jesus, redeem me from the curse of the law. Be made a curse for me. Mm-hmm. That the blessings of Abraham, healing is a blessing. Jesus bore my sickness and I started quoting the word.
Yes, yes.
And disease on the cross, and by his stripes, I'm healed.
Amen.
I command you, bacteria, to die.
Amen.
I curse you in Jesus' name. You will stop your operations now in the name of Jesus. I'm not going to have it. And the whole, and of course, you know how the enemy talks, right? In that subtle voice, you're going to die. You're going to die.
Oh, yeah.
And I said, I'm not going to die. I will live and declare the word of the Lord.
Come on.
And everything that the enemy was trying to come against me in, I said, no, I stand upon the promises of God. They are yes and amen. To the glory of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And then the Holy Spirit, you know, he's so good. He tells me what to take. He said, you better go and take some of your hydroperoxide. I do a hydroperoxide drink, and it just kills all bacteria and things in my body. It goes after fungus, bacteria, you know, any kind of things that cause problems, you know, in your body. Hydroperoxide takes care of it, but it has to be the right kind. You have to know
what
you're doing.
Right.
Not anybody can take it. It has to be. Claim it.
All right, I think Pastor Marshall, you're frozen. No.
Yeah, I know. Oh no. Oh no. Not sure, Pastor Marsha, if you can hear me. You are frozen. Let me see. Not sure if it's reconnecting on her side or I lost her. Okay, let's see if I can. Let's see if I can. All right, I don't see her back yet. Let's see if I can re-add her when she gets back. All right, revival, everybody. Revival does start with us. And you know, when we are carrying the glory of God on the inside of us, there is no stopping revival from happening because that glory wants to reach others. That glory has a desire for souls saved. Amen. That glory has a desire to serve. So, like I said, I've said many times over, I'll keep saying it. It doesn't matter about the title necessarily as much as it matters that we know that we are servants above all. Jesus came to serve. He came to save the lost. He came to heal the sick and dying. He didn't come for those that were well. Amen. And so he served. When you look at Jesus's lifestyle, he served. Amen. And so we have to follow that example. We have to serve. We have to set time aside to spend with the Father. We have to set time aside to get to know who our Daddy is so that we can carry the glory of God on the inside of us, so that we can become the servant that Jesus was and go around healing the sick and raising the dead and walking on water. You know, people need what we have. And freely it was given to us, so freely we should give to others. Amen. Amen. Let me see. I still don't see Pastor Marsha on here. Okay, I'm wondering if. Okay. I don't know. I don't know if she's gonna come back on. I will keep watching for her. But anyway, as we've heard from Pastor Marsha, her desire is for revival. That's her passion. It's for revival. And I know that some of you on here have that same passion for revival. Amen. And like I said, it starts with us. It starts with us. We have to get out there and touch lives. If you think about it, how did you come to Jesus? Somebody had to reach out to you. Somebody was praying for you. Somebody was a servant and came to you. Amen. Somewhere a seed was planted. So we are supposed to be carriers of that same servanthood, that same anointing, that same glory, that same desire, that same passion that Jesus had for souls. We need to carry that same passion. Amen. It's all about souls. It's all about souls. It's all about lighting the fire with others. Amen. All righty. Let me see. Still no Pastor Marsha. Okay. I guess we lost her, guys. But I will probably be circling around again anyway, with all of these amazing women that I've been having come on Real Talk. It's just been awesome. I still have a whole list to get through. So it's gonna be amazing. It's gonna be good. Amen. It's gonna be good. We just gotta remember souls. Oh, there she is, Pastor Marsha. Let's see. Yeah, I don't see where I can add you again. I know I was just saying, oh no, we were almost at the end. But like I was saying, Pastor Marsha has a passion and desire for revival. And I don't know what happened either. You froze and then you were gone, and I see you on, but I I don't see the add button again. But I was just saying, I will be circling back again, and having ladies come on again. You know, the different, all of you different pastors. Thank you, Pastor Marsha. It was such a blessing having you on and sharing your heart. We will be doing this again. This is not just the first and last. Amen. I will be connecting with you more, and I'm so excited to bring revival to Maui. I know it's already started here and in the islands, but let me tell you what, once we get filled with the glory of God, that we are carriers of that fire, we are carriers of that revival. Amen. There is nothing that can stop us. And as we know, with fire, it spreads. Amen. It spreads. So I am so blessed that Pastor Marsha took the time to come on here and share with us that wonderful word. And I am now going to, okay, I just put my link up, Pastor Cynthia. If you're on here, let me know if you see it. She's my go-to. Anyway, I put a link up and it takes you to my webpage, Salvation page. If you do not know Jesus, that's what this is all about. We do this for souls. We do this because we want to give away the free gift God gave us, and that's salvation, so we can spend eternity in the kingdom of heaven with our loved ones, with God. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Cynthia. So I know the link is up. If you want to know Jesus, click on that link. Say that prayer. Get hooked up with a local church. And look, if you don't know where there's a local church, then you can message us here and someone will answer you. If you need prayer, you can message as well. You know, Pastor Marsha, who's on here, like, she lives in Kona on the Big Island, and she and her husband, Pastor Kona Christian Church, a great place to go and get fed. She also does all these different things with, you know, Women of Destiny and, you know, the extension that she talked about doing that. And so get hooked up, link arms. That's what we're here for, to link arms. Thank you. I love you too, Pastor Marsha. Thank you so much. Anyways, let me close this up in prayer. Father, I just thank you. I was going to have Pastor Marsha do it, but we got disconnected. Father, I just thank you. I thank you for this time that you gave us. I thank you for Pastor Marsha for taking the time to come and bless us. And I pray that you would bless her 100-fold, God, the way she has poured out to us, that you would pour back into her. I pray that you would bless Kona Christian Church and Women of Destiny and Hawaii Healing Revival and all the things that she is endeavoring to put her hands to the plow, God. I thank you that she is a woman after your own heart, God. Continue to move in her and through her mightily to bring forth the revival that you have put in her heart. God, who you appoint, you also anoint. So I pray for a double portion of your anointing to be upon Pastor Marsha right now in the name of Jesus. Move her, God. Order her steps in the way that she should go, Father. I thank you. I thank you for all of it in the mighty name of your precious son, Jesus. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you all again so much for joining. I will be on tomorrow morning at 7, right back here with Women of War Mornings with God. It was a great word. I love you all so much. Be blessed. Amen.